Verset 10.
And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed. Look up. Jabez called on the God of Israel.
Jabez invoqua le nom de Dieu.
Oh, that thou wouldest bless me.
Que si tu me bénis.
Indeed.
Enfin.
Jabez did not say, oh, that thou wouldest bless me. He didn't say, oh, that thou wouldest bless me. He said, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed. Because there are things around him that looks like blessing.
Il y a des choses qui sont comme la
bénédiction. But they were not blessing.
C'est pas la
bénédiction. There might have been prophecy for a man
qui peut
to
avoir
say,
les prophéties.
For a man to say, ah, at least let me have money indeed.
Quelqu'un peut avoir enfin
it
l'argent.
Means there have been things around him that looks like money, but it's not a reality.
Sont comme la, mais c'est pas la réalité.
Am I talking to somebody? There is something called an apparition.
Quelque chose comme pépin.
What looks like a reality, but it's not real.
Qui est comme la réalité, mais c'est pas réel.
There are many believers whose life is like an apparition.
Il y a beaucoup de chrétiens qui le vivent comme une apparition.
Somebody look at you and they just can't believe you are not. Have you seen single people? Some of them, they will ask them our family. Because they look married.
Tu as vu un
célibataire? So your prayer is that let me marry indeed.
Et tu dois te marier enfin.
There are people, if you look at them, they look rich.
Regardes,
but they are not rich. Let me be rich indeed.
Enfin.
There are people whose accents are flawless.
Leur accent, quand ils parlent,
when they talk, you think they have been around the world. They've not crossed the shores
partout.
Of this country.
Mais quelle adresse?
Visa denied.
Ils n'ont pas de visa.
Let me go out indeed.
Que je voyage enfin.
In life.
Dans la vie.
If you don't give up, your problem will give up.
Si tu n'abandonnes pas ton problème, abandonnera.
I've said this over the years. For any enemy who is ready to fight, God is also ready.
Dieu aussi prêt.
For any devil that says it's ready to fight, God is also ready.
Dieu aussi prêt.
If you don't give up, your problems will give up.
Si tu n'abandonnes pas ton problème, abandonnera.
Second night in Napoli, it was a crusade we had in Italy. Open crusade, massive crowd.
Très grand.
The second day morning session, it was raining.
Il pleuvait.
I was already okay. It was drizzling. Then I heard the mic, and it was raining.
J'ai pris le microphone.
And I saw people moving to the corner, covering. And I asked myself a question:
Is
it me that will close a program because of rain?
Est-ce moi qui dois arrêter?
It's not possible.
C'est pas possible.
This rain will close, not me will close.
Cette pluie va s'arrêter, non moi.
I started prophesying in the rain.
J'ai prophétisé sous la pluie.
And I said to them, I said, in few minutes, sun will shine.
Dans quelques jours, la lumière
vient. I said, now you are running from rain, very soon you'll be running from sun.
Je suppose vous allez fuir le soleil.
I said, I'm not going anywhere.
Je vais
nulle part. All the pastors were looking at me.
Les pasteurs ont regardé.
Soaked ministry.
J'ai rendu ministère.
Ministry.
Sous la pluie.
They were, some were covering umbrellas with the rain.
Les parapluies.
The wind of God blew.
Le vent de Dieu est venu.
The rain stopped.
Le vent
in 5 minutes, they were covering umbrellas for the sun.
En 5 minutes, couvert à cause du soleil.
Now, I said to the pastor, I'm teaching you something.
J'ai dit au pasteur,
if you don't
chose,
give up,
tu n'abandonnes pas,
your problem will give up.
Ton problème abandonnera.
If a little thing, I say, hey, you don't, for what? For what?
Pourquoi?
You've got to get to that point in life.
Tu dois arriver au niveau dans la vie.
Where until you get what you want,
parce
don't want what you get.
Rien ne fait ce que tu veux.
Am I talking to somebody?
Est-ce que je m'adresse à quelqu'un?
It has to be what you want. So you will pray.
Ce que tu veux. Tu dois prier.
Bless me indeed.
Bénis-moi enfin.
The Bible said Jabez looked more honorable than his brethren. When Jabez appeared,
quand
he looked honorable.
Il était considéré que les autres.
He looked like honor, but there was no honor.
Il n'était pas honoré.
It was a deception.
C'était une déception.
A deception.
Une déception.
It is also called a grandiose delusion.
Ça veut dire aussi une délusion grandiose.
Grandiose delusion.
Une délusion grandiose.
There are people whose life is going downslide.
Il y a des gens qui la vie ne font que descendre.
Downslide.
Ne fait que descendre.
You will pray this prayer with holy anger.
Tu vas prier avec une colère sainte.
Lord, in this season we are in now.
Que Seigneur, en cette saison que je traverse.
Bless me indeed.
Bénis-moi enfin.
Bless me indeed.
Bénis-moi
lift your
enfin.
Right hand on fire. Say, my Father, my Maker.
Father, my Maker.
Shout it loud and clear.
My Father, my Maker.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
In this season of my life.
In this season of my life.
Bless me indeed.
Bless me indeed.
Open your mouth and collect the blessing.
La Pushakada.
Ibrakasa,
Ibrakasa,
Ibrakasa, Ibrakasa, Ibrakasa,
shakatalata ikalada shalalalalala ekalabarata shalalalata He said, bless me indeed.
La bénie mon enfant.
And enlarge my coast.
Mes limites.
Hold it.
Coast.
Mes limites.
Enlarge my coast.
Étend mes limites.
Increase my opportunity.
Augmente mes opportunités.
Expand my opportunity.
Expand mes opportunités.
God does not give people money.
Dieu ne donne pas l'argent.
Except on very strange basis, which are very strange.
C'est étrange.
Like Kenneth E. Hagin,
Kenneth E. Hagin,
a man of God, Papa Hagin was praying one time.
Cet homme de Dieu priait un jour.
It was a die-hard, desperate situation.
Il voulait d'argent.
He was in a major fix in a corner.
Il était dans une situation.
And prayed some dangerous strength prayer after sacrifice. And money literally landed on his bed.
L'argent est venu sur son lit.
$50,000 landed physically. That is not a usual occurrence.
C'est pas une chose habituelle.
But there is a usual occurrence God does.
Il y a une chose habituelle que Dieu fait.
God doesn't give people cash.
Dieu ne donne pas aux gens l'argent.
He gives them opportunities.
Mais il donne les opportunités
to make cash.
Pour faire de l'argent.
When opportunities are properly channeled as divine raw materials.
Sont bien dirigées par
they are processed into currency. So when you say enlarge my coast, you are saying give me more opportunities. And there's something about God. When God gives you opportunities,
quand Dieu donne les opportunités,
he handles it.
Il s'occupe de ça.
He handles the enemies that are fighting your opportunities.
Il s'occupe de l'ennemi qui te combat.
When God gives you opportunities,
quand Dieu donne les opportunités,
he said the blessings of God make it rich and add
it.
Expand my opportunities. Give me opportunities.
Donne-moi les opportunités.
Expand.
Étend mes limites.
Opportunities also means can also mean meeting the right people.
Les opportunités venir rencontrer la vraie personne.
Opportunity can also mean being stationed at the right place at the right time.
Être dans le bon endroit au bon moment.
Give me opportunities.
Donne-moi les opportunités.
Give me.
Donne-moi.
The race is not to the swift. The battle is not to the strong. Not bread to men of skill. Not riches to men of understanding. But time. And what? Chance.
Opportunity.
Donne-moi les opportunités.
Happened to them or it happens to everybody.
Ça veut dire à tout le monde.
You will pray.
Tu vas prier.
Lord, increase my opportunities.
Oh Seigneur, augmente mes opportunités.
There are people who only meet one helper in their lifetime.
Il y a des gens qui en ont seulement un seul assistant toute leur vie.
When God strategically positions you,
quand Dieu les place d'une manière stratégique,
divine timing,
le temps divin,
divine sensitivity,
la sensibilité divine,
Are you ready?
Est-ce que vous êtes prêt?
Lift your right hand.
Lève ta main notre feu.
Say my Father, my Maker.
My Father, my Maker.
Pray this prayer like somebody who is standing before the Almighty. Shout it again.
My Father, my Maker.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Increase my opportunity.
Increase my opportunity.
Then put your mouth and fire prayer.
Oh, the Shikarata. Karushataba. Mosi kabila zirutade. Shalala. Ila la 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 la. Karushala. Karushitabana sila. God, increase my opportunities. Iya Baragasha. Iya Baragasha. Iya Baragasha. Iya Baragasha. Iya Baragasha. Iya Baragasha. Eka Lisha Kata Suprikata. Lele. Iya Number three.
Troisième sujet de prière.
He said, let your hand be.
Que ta main soit sur moi.
He didn't say be upon me. He said, let your hand be with.
Que ta main soit avec moi.
Hein? Let your hand be with.
Que ta main soit avec
moi. The literal
moi.
Word should have been be.
Ça devait plutôt être
upon me.
Être sur moi.
The hand of God.
La main de Dieu.
Speaks of the support of God.
Ça parle
the
du soutien
leadership
de Dieu.
Of God. So when and to be with,
être avec,
it means to relate.
Ça veut dire en relation.
It means to be connected.
Être connecté.
Eh? It's a joint word. Now when he said, "Let your hand be with me," and the hand of God speaks of support, he was trying to say, "Let me permanently be connected to your support."
Que je sois connecté permanentement.
Not just upon, but with.
Avec toi.
When you intermingle, how do I explain this?
Avec Dieu.
Let me have an intercourse with the Holy
j'ai
Spirit.
Une relation personnelle avec le Saint-Esprit.
An intercourse.
Très profonde avec le Saint-Esprit.
Be with me.
Sois avec moi.
Not just upon.
Pas
permanently
moi.
At a realm where permanently
une relation
enjoy
permanent se réjouit.
Divine support.
Le soutien de Dieu.
Ah Yagabasaka. I was boiling over the week and I was telling mom, I said, I'm not just happy.
J'étais pas content cette semaine.
You may have heard the news, what happened in South Carolina. You may have heard about it. A 21-year-old boy entered the church.
Entre l'église.
And a certain Emmanuel Baptist Church. Emmanuel Church, where a pastor was preaching the Bible study.
Le pasteur enseignait.
And the boy sat behind the crowd, at the back of the crowd.
Était assis
derrière. And after the Bible study, he went, he locked the door, killed the pastor, killed all the members.
Après l'étude, il a tué le pasteur.
And I said to my wife, I said, where is the Lord God of Elijah?
Où est le Dieu d'Élie? J'ai crié.
Can you shoot a native doctor and the gun will enter?
Tu peux tirer sur un traducteur.
You shoot a herbalist, God will bounce. You shoot a pastor, he die. Why?
Pourquoi?
And she says something. I say I got it.
Quelque chose.
The in the days of our fathers, the Archbishop in the house, robbers came to his house. They're shooting guns, and he was going out. The wife held him. He said, "Leave me. They have their weapon. Let me get my weapon."
He carried a Bible.
He said, how many of you are outside? They shouted 25. He said, I'm going to count to 5. And when I get to 5, I kill all of you. 1, 2, 3. And he burst his door as he was. He got bamba. They took off. You know why? She said something which I said, this is true. He said, in those days, the way they fear God is different from now.
Est différent de nos jours.
Check a herbalist. A herbalist want to enter his shrine. If you wear your slippers, a herbalist some will enter with their back. They have reference for their place of worship. But in church, message can be going on. Somebody's replying text.
Mais à l'église, le message passe. Quelqu'un en train de répondre les textes.
There's no fear.
Il n'y a pas de crainte de Dieu.
People can be quarreling during the message. A pastor can be preaching and somebody else is saying something else against what he's saying.
Pendant qu'on prêche,
so because there's no reference, there's no power.
De Dieu, il n'y a pas la puissance de Dieu parce qu'il n'y a pas la crainte de Dieu.
And the man was not just a pastor, the man was a state senator. And there was something Obama said when he was talking. He said a place that we are supposed to run to for refuge.
And I'm supposed to être comme le refuge.
I said to myself, I said, this is a ridicule. I said, look at where they are talking about church now.
Yes,
they kill them in the church. I said, look at where they are saying it. And my phone was full from my children in America sending messages. Some are going to fasting. They said, Papa, this is an abuse. I said to them, don't send me this text again. When good things happen in the church, do you post send me text? One bad thing now, they're amplifying it. And you know CNN, they have no news. They will carry one news, flog it for 4 days. Very funny set of people. When they carry one bad news, they will x-ray it. The boy is now becoming a hero. And I told them in Italy, I said, that's why I love Nigeria. This boy, by now, the one that is releasing the Holy Ghost fire on him, the one that is killing him physically, he was smiling, he was handcuffed, he was smiling. After wasting a man of God, wasting member, killed everybody. He spared one woman and told the woman, I'm sparing you so you can go and tell others.
Là, ça m'a fait esquiver une femme. Il a parti une femme pour qu'elle aille dire les autres.
To make matters worse, he loaded his gun 5 times. Something down the spot. His pistol, his revolver, you know, pistol got exalted, loaded it again.
Il a pris
I said, what happened to?
Il a pris tout le temps pour faire tout cela. Et les gens l'observaient.
Scream in the hotel room. I said, where is the Lord God of Elijah? I was preaching AB Uzziah years ago, and some court boy said I spoke against their court, and they entered into where I was staying. And where I was staying, they said, I think Reverend John was with me. They said, open the gate. The man was, I said, open the gate. And he opened the gate, and the power of God knocked them down. They fell. I said, if any one of you is able to stand up, I will set fire on my Bible. They were struggling on the ground. And I said, you see, the reference that our fathers had for God.
La référence que nos papas avaient.
During worship, you see them crying. How many people cry now?
La même prière,
if you see a young man crying during service, it, two things. Either there's a girl he's trying to impress, or there's something he's trying to steal. You see a lady crying, either there's something bad she has remembered. People hardly pray and you see them in the place of worship crying.
Les gens ne pleurent plus devant Dieu.
See them worshiping God.
Glory Dieu.
See people worshiping God.
Comme les gens adorent Dieu.
There's no more power.
Il y a plus la puissance de Dieu à l'église.
And that's why in Europe they were asking me, sir. We saw people stand up from the wheelchair in the Italy program. You still came in the morning. You came. We saw you climbing the place, speaking in tongues. Led prayer throughout. Came down speaking in tongues. I said, let's go back to the Christianity of the 80s.
Vous voulez que nous rentrons aux chrétiens de 1980?
I heard the Archbishop say this morning, by one, I was on my knees. God was talking to me by 2, by 3, by 4, by 5, by 6. I started looking at the man. Then he was about 50. This man was on his knees for 5 hours. At that age. There is no power in the church.
Il n'y a plus de puissance à l'église.
Am I communicating?
Est-ce qu'il me reste à quelqu'un?
Let your hand be with me.
Que ta main soit avec moi.
With me,
avec moi.
John Hagee is a preacher in America. He's a man who has a special revelation on end times.
La révélation spéciale.
A stubborn young man burst into his church and began to shoot, and came close to him, and emptied a gun on him, over 38 bullets. Pop, 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 everything empty, and the man asked him, "Are you true?"
Not true. On a fini. On a dit que est-ce que tu as fini?
Yes. Members scattered. They were looking at pastor, looking at gun. The power of God only manifests where there is the fear of God.
La puissance de Dieu se manifeste quand il y a la crainte de Dieu.
The more the fear, the more the power.
Plus on craint de Dieu, plus la puissance en main.
The lower the power.
Plus moins on craint Dieu, moins la puissance.
We just see one testimony. We cry, hey, thank God. But it could have been greater if the fear was massive.
Si y a la crainte de
people
Dieu.
People can come to the house of God without a Bible.
Non, le Dieu sans la Bible.
People come without Bible. Just iPad. The man of God is preaching. They press. They just came for prophecy. They came for. Come and perform. Come. The church has become like a political gathering.
L'église est devenue comme un rassemblement de politiciens.
Am I communicating?
Est-ce que
lift your right hand of fire.
Lève ton feu.
Say, my father. As I begin to pray, from today, let your hand be with me.
Let your hand be with me.
Open your mouth and fire prayer. Lift your hands and worship him. You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasures that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeking you as my precious jewel, Lord, to give up I'll be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb when I am weak, you are the treasures that I see. You are my all in all. Seeking you as my precious joy. Love to give up, I'll be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, everybody, wherever you are now.
Hallelujah.
And when I was down, you lifted me.
Hallelujah.
I had no home. I had no home. You gave me a shelter. People laughed and snubbed at me. But look at me now. I'm a living testimony. Yes, you are Lord. Yes, you are Lord. Yes, you are Lord. Yes, you are Lord.
And when I was down, you lifted me. I had no home, you gave me your shelter. People laughed and snubbed at me.
Thank you, Lord.
But look at me now, I'm a living testimony. Yes, we are. Bow down and worship him. We will bow down and worship him. Worship him. Oh, worship him. Jesus, the King of Kings. Jesus,
the King of Kings.
Lift your hands and worship Jesus. There is power in this house. God will do it again and again and again. He's the same God today as he always has been, yesterday and today and forever the same. There's no reason to doubt, God will do it again. Time after time,
I hear people say to me, why are there no miracles as they used to be? I believe in miracles. God hears me when I call. This one thing I know today is the same God today. God will do it again and again and again. He's the same God today as he always has been, yesterday and today and forever the same. There's no reason to doubt, God will do it again. Time after time,
hallelujah.
I hear people say to me, why are there no miracles as they used to be? I believe in miracles. Yes, me when I call. This one thing I know, it's the same God today. God will do it again and again and again. It's the same God today as he always, always has been, yesterday and today and forever.
Throw your words around and prove to the devil that you are master. The sick be healed and lost be found. In Jesus' name I pray. Let me hear that amen like thunder. God bless you. You may be seated in his wonderful presence. I bring you a word briefly from the book of Judges, chapter 16, verse 28. Judges 16, verse 28. Have you found it? And Samson called on the Lord, unto the Lord, and said, oh Lord God, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, only this once. Oh God, that I may be at once avenged of the Philistines for my two eyes. Very briefly, I want to speak on the God of a second chance. Somebody say, God of a second chance. Samson slept on the laps of a woman and woke up. His history was rewritten. It is better not to wake up at all than to wake up empty. It is better not to wake up at all than to wake up and discover that all you have labored for in life, you have lost them in a hurry. If Samson had known that when he woke up from that lap, he would have seen shame, he would have not woken up at all. If Samson had known that when he woke up from that place, it was disgrace waiting for him, he would have not woken up at all. But there is something else I know. The fact that you woke up at all means it's not over. I said the fact that he woke up at all means it's not over. When the devil start messing, God start blessing. I said when the devil start messing, God start blessing. I don't know what has has happened to you while men slept. If men slept, men can wake up. And when you wake up, it's a restoration time. God sent me to tell you, no matter the error of your life, there is a second chance. No matter the mistake you made, there is a second chance. No matter what has happened to you, there is a second chance. You don't serve a dead God. You serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday. He's the same today. He's the same forever. When God says yes, no man can say no. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. God is on your side. Power is on your side. Glory is on your side. Favor is on your side. Lift the wind, shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let me tell somebody, there is a second chance.
Take your seat.
I come to tell you, God does not lift the standing.
God lifts the falling.
If you are on the ground, it is a sign that you are a candidate for lifting. Your present state is not your final status. The end of the day is not the end of the story. A bus stop is not a full stop. Behind every end, there is a bend. I prophesy by the power of Yeshua. As you hear the sound of my voice, there is a word from heaven over someone's life. It doesn't matter how many times you fall. A righteous man falleth.
A righteous man falleth. If he's righteous, why did he fall? You didn't hear that. A righteous man falleth. How many times? And riseth up. Now, hold on. If he's righteous, why did he fall? You are not your offense. You are not your offense.
A righteous man.
Meaning, your weakness does not define your personality.
A righteous man falleth.
When he fell once, that should have been enough.
Seven times.
But riseth up again. I'm here to tell somebody who feels that you've made certain mistakes in your life, or you feel you've lost everything. Situation has beaten you hands down. You have seen your life slide. You have seen you lose everything. You have fallen into depths. You were once operating in escalating heights, but now you are falling into depth. I mean, you are sliding with gargantuan metamorphosis, and you are saying to yourself, does it mean this is the end of life? God sent me to tell you, there is a second chance for you. I said there is a second chance for your life. There is a second chance for your family. There is a second chance for you. And he said to Ezekiel, son of man, can these bones live again? And he said, oh Lord, thou knowest. And he said, prophesy upon the bones. And Ezekiel said, I prophesied as I was commanded, and behold, that's what will happen to you. Behold, in your marriage, behold, in your business, behold, your finances, behold. And he said, bone came together unto his bone. Dry bones will rise again. Your marriage will rise again. Your finance will rise again. Your health will rise again. I say your family will rise again. Your academics will rise again. I say you shall rise again. I say you shall rise again. I say you shall rise again.
I say you shall rise again.
Amen.
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 Lift your hand, shout fire. He said, I prophesy as I was commanded. This morning I am commanded. There is a command on my life. God said I should prophesy. And right now I prophesy. It is not over. You will rise again. You will shine again. You will smile again. Tell somebody there is a second chance.
In a second chance.
Take your seat. Take your seat. Samson was held captive. Samson was held what? Captive. Captivity is when you fall into the expectation of your enemies. Captivity. The Bible says in verse 21 of that same chapter, they put him in a prison house. And he began to ground. Every form of captivity. Samson was a man who was kept in a prison house to grind. He was grinding. A human being began to do the work of a machine. He was grinding. Captivity is any form of abuse to human dignity. Any form of abuse. There is something about the devil. If you let him use you, he will use you till you are useless. That's something about the devil. If you allow him use you, he will use you till you are useless. Captivity. He said all the people, the Philistines, he was sent to kill. He said they gathered and they began to mock him. They said, where is the man that destroyed us? When the things you master before begin to master you, is captivity. When the things you were born to overcome begin to overcome you, is captivity. When the things you were born to conquer begin to conquer you, is captivity. When the things you were born to live and lord over begin to live and lead and lord over you, it is captivity. But there is a word from heaven. From captivity, you are becoming a celebrity. That your amen is not correct. In verse 24, the Bible said they were rejoicing. Captivity is any form of satanic conclusion on your affliction. Captivity, look at what they did. The Bible says, first of all, they arrested him. After a while, they blinded his eyes. After a while, he began to grind. You see the process? Gradual, consistent affliction is what bets ultimate extinction. Gradual, consistent affliction is what bets, what give birth to ultimate extinction. If the devil want to finish a man, it gives him gradual affliction. Something takes his finance, something takes his health, something takes his marriage, something takes his job, something takes his family, then something takes his life. And that's why anytime you see any form of affliction, stop it from going further. Say, you have come this far, you will go no further. Somebody say, Satan! What kind of people do you have here? Say, Satan! You have gone this far, you will go no further. Say, witchcraft! You have gone this far, you will go no further.
You call upon.
Say, marine spirits. You have gone this far.
You call this far.
You will go no further.
You call upon.
Say, herbalist power.
Herbalist power.
You have gone this far.
You call this far.
You will go no further.
You call upon.
Say, family altar. You have gone this far.
You call this far.
You will go no further.
You call upon.
My foundation.
My foundation.
You have gone this far. on, Holy Ghost.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
Take your seat. Take your seat. Take your seat. I like what I saw. I like what I saw. After the Philistines captured Samson, they gave a sacrifice. People, we are taught in church that we give sacrifices when we are expecting something. But these people gave a sacrifice after their testimony has come. I hear people say, I'm giving a sacrifice so that God will do this. But these people understood that you give when it is done. You also give. You give before it's done, and you also give a sacrifice when it's done. There are people that would do everything to get a child, but on the day of their baby dedication, they put one flat in an envelope. They give a sacrifice after they caught Samson. Took out his eyes. The ultimate of affliction and captivity is distortion of vision. To distort your vision. To make you clueless over your destiny. You have no clue on why you are born. Can I shock you? The poor man is not the man whose account is unread. The poor man is not a man who has not got contact. The poor man is not a man who can feed. The poor man is a man who doesn't know why he was born. Can I talk to you? After this morning, you will discover your destiny. Can I talk to you? The reason why you were born. The reason why you were created. The reason why you came to this world. I prophesy. After this morning's service, you will discover your purpose. I say you will discover your purpose. I say you discover your purpose. I say you discover your purpose. I say you discover your purpose. Let me tell 7 people, I will discover, I will discover,
I will discover.
Take your seat. Take your seat. They gathered. They gathered in a room. Watch me. They gathered, I like this one. They gathered in a room, in a hall, and they said to the lords of the Philistine, call Samson to come and make sport. Let's use him as a jest. In other words, let's use Samson for drama. They didn't know that was the room they were going to die. God made sure they gathered very well. God made sure they gathered all the lords of the Philistine. Those that matter, they gather. It was supposed to be Samson's drama, but they didn't know it was their dilemma. Hey, what they plan to use as your drama, it will be their dilemma. Hey! Ay, 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 ay. As they gather to mock you, that place where they gather, thunder shall blast. I said thunder shall blast. Lift your one shout. Yes. Take your seat. Now look at this. Please, can you take your seat 1 minute? Samson was in the hands of his enemy. The enemy had him. They had him by the groins. Samson was in their hand. How can you think of coming out of a situation when you're already in the hands of your enemies? Some of you, the enemy that has held you is sickness. Doctor gave you a report that looks like conclusive. And now you're wondering, how come I enter the hand of my enemies? Some of you, is where you walk, there is a gang up. You turn to the left, to the right, there's nothing. It's like you are in the hand of your enemies. Some of you, it is an academic challenge where a man has made himself a pharaoh that you can't cross. It's like you are in the hand of your enemies. Some of you is a pattern in your family line. What has happened to others before, and it has done now. You're in the hand of your Samson was there. Your enemies may include you, but they can't conclude you. Your enemies may analyze you, but they can't paralyze you. You are just there now. There are people who, if a man who thousand, Bible said 3,000 lords gathered against one man, they felt it was over. There are people who are giving medical reports and they say, there's nothing. It's as though you are in the hands of your enemies. And some of you, it may have been because of your carelessness. Samson lived that life and made mistakes. The hand. You found yourself in a marriage you didn't budget for. You are living a life you are not happy. Say, this is not the kind of marriage I wanted. It's as though you are in the hands of your enemies. Am I talking to somebody here? I look at the life of Samson and I discover certain attributes in his life that manifested, that made God remember him. Samson did not pray for remembrance until he had put things in place. Remembrance doesn't fall on people. They are triggered by principles. Remembrance doesn't fall on people. They are triggered. Now look at me. If you study your Bible very well, you will discover that Samson was a man that was always outside. Samson never stayed inside. Samson was always outside. Samson was anointed to destroy the Philistines, but the Philistines became his best friend. Diversion of destiny. The things he was meant to destroy are the things he began to befriend. But can I shock you? Can I shock you? Samson was not just befriending the Philistines. He was befriending their harlots. The harlots are the ones that sane men have rejected. Samson was now following what the enemies have rejected. When you go into sin, you will go far. Now watch me. And I began to see Samson for the first time in Samson's life. When he was arrested, he had time to stay indoors. What he never did, it was problem that made him do it. If God is calling you and you are running, he knows how to trap you. He will bring problem that will drive you to the closet. If you like, rebuke it if it happens. I'm telling you, keep running. If God wants you in Kaduna and you are in London, he will deport you. Keep running. You are too busy. The first thing we saw that gave Samson a second chance was the principle of separation. Separated himself. Many of us are too busy. Somebody just suggests a business principle without praying, without taking time to ask God. Pew. You jump into it. Am I talking to somebody? I was called to the church. Someone said to me that we should have a crusade in Moscow, Russia, that they had an opening and they wanted us to go there. It sounds like a good idea. And I've told you, not all good ideas are God's ideas, but all God's ideas are good ideas. And I was praying for this opportunity to preach the gospel in Russia. I was born to preach. I was born to preach. If you take me to the bank to work, I will dash everybody the money. You take me to a medical institution to treat people, I will choke injection on the wrong person. I was born to preach. And I went to God when I saw that concept. They told us the opportunities there. In some places in the Soviet Union, they are watching me now, the former Soviet Union, they still hide the Bible. They are still scared to preach. So I love to go to places that people are running from. So when I was praying, God said to me, have you asked me? And I went to him, Father, there's an opening in Russia. Yahweh, Yahweh, you are glorious, so glorious in your way. This was a prayer of inquiry. You are wonderful, so wonderful in your way. Yahweh, Yahweh, you are glorious, so glorious in your way. You are powerful, so powerful in your way. Awesome, so awesome
in your way.
And you are mighty, so mighty in your way. As I was worshiping it, and my spirit was open, I heard the voice of the Lord. Not time. Not time. Not time. Not time. And I called them. I said, not time. What's that? As you separate yourself. Proverbs 18 verse 1. True desire. A man having separated himself, intermediate with all wisdom. You know Solomon? What killed Solomon was that he was talking, people were gathering to listen to him. He kept talking. He was not recouping. He kept talking, they were clapping, till they started frowning because he was talking nonsense. When you are not more inspired, you expire. Solomon, people were clapping. He didn't have time to withdraw. He didn't have time to recoup and reorganize himself. There are things God can't do for a man that's everywhere. If you are everywhere, you'll be nowhere. Withdraw. Samson never had time to withdraw. People say, why don't you pick calls, apostle? Why don't you only spend time? And I said to them, I studied the life of great men. And I discovered what made them expire as they were increasing was there too much time for people and no time for God. And when you lose touch with God, people know. When the presence is still strong, people know. So they kept attending till they just get to people, oh, thank you, Father. And you know something about the gift of God is without repentance. It keeps manifesting, but the presence is with repentance. A man coming from God's presence, when he takes a microphone, atmosphere changes. You just know this one has been with God. One day the archbishop walked into a meeting and took the mic. I started crying. I didn't know I was crying. Before he came up, all kinds of people were talking, all kinds of atmosphere was dry. It was a volume 5 anointing. People were dozing, and as he came, just took a song. And I said, I just was weeping. See, this man has been with God. If God wants you in the closet and you are in the open, he knows how to kidnap you. Keep running. God said, do his work. You are doing business. No problem. You will owe and owe and owe and owe until you carry the Bible. God is calling you to stay in Nigeria and do something. Abroad is in your mind. You tried before, you failed. You are still planning to go. This second time, you won't come back. There are people, how can somebody travel by land? Is that not illegal? You go through Libya. They arrest you, release you. Some die in the sea. Some from there, they take you to the refugee camp. Look at the process of human debasement. When some people travel up to Europe today, come back tomorrow. Some people on virgin passport get new visas. My son, was it virgin passport? Himself is the pastor of our church in America, Maryland. Is it Maryland? I'll be with them in about less than 2 months. First, fresh virgin passport. Gave him a visa, gave his wife, gave his 3 children. Virgin passport. Two years. Why? Because somebody chose to do it the right way. Pass through Libya. I have no sympathy for people like that. Some are sending me account numbers. I've been arrested in Libya. It was a soldier that used the phone. Please, daddy, send me money. And I told one of them, he was here. I've given him 2 prophecies twice. I said, don't travel. He still travel. He says, in Libya. I said, send me money. So they will release me. I said, I send you. Eh? Did I send you? Only you waka go. Waka come.
Tell 5 people, separate yourself. Ah! 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 7. He said, come out from among them and be separate. Acts chapter 13.